Factoring Examples by Alison Hammack. Problem number one. We're given a trinomial, three terms, and we're asked to factor it. For this problem, we're going to use the reverse Foyle smile method. So when I look at 49, what things multiply to be 49? Well, 7 times 7 does. And I look at the number here in the end, 9. 9 is 3 times 3, or 9 times 1. This also could be 49 times 1. I'm always going to start with the numbers that are closer together. So I'm going to start with this pair, and I'm going to start with this pair. Now, they may not be the right numbers to use, but I always start with the numbers that are closer together. A trinomial always factors into two binomials. So let's first, in this first position, put these factors. So I would have a 7y times 7y. Then I'm going to put the 3 and 3 in these positions here. And my smile will check if I've done this correctly, because my smile checks for the middle term. So 3 times 7y is a 21y. And then I have a lower smile. 7y times 3 is also 21y. Down here, I put what I want to get. This is what I want to get. I'm going to put it down here. I'm trying to get a 42y. Well, I would get there if both of these have a positive sign, then this will add to be 42y. So I knew that both of these need to be positive. Okay? And then I have my factors. Now, I could also check it by doing the Foyle method. I can also check just the last term. Positive 3 times a positive 3 is a positive 9. So these are the factors for this problem. Number 2. 3s squared minus 8s minus 16. Again, I want to factor this. So 3 is 3 times 1. 16 could be 4 times 4. It could be 8 times 2. It could be 16 times 1. I'm going to start with a pair that are closer together. So I have 3s times s. And then my 4s will go in these positions, 4 and 4. Now I need to do my smile. 4 times s is 4s. 3s times 4 is 12s. I'm trying to get a negative. I need a negative 8s. So I bring this down here. So in order to get a negative 8s, I would need this number to be the negative and this to be the positive. And then they would combine, they would add to be a negative 8s. So my positive is attached to my 4s. My negative is attached to this term over here. And then lastly, let me just check. Is a positive 4 times a negative 16 a negative 16? Yes. So I'm done. These are my factors. Number 3. 80b to the 4th minus 36b to the 3rd. Plus 4b squared. So when I first look at this problem, I want to, step one, I want to take out the GCF. All of these numbers share a 4, and they share a b squared. So I first want to take a 4b squared out of this trinomial. When I do that, I'm left with 20b squared minus 9b plus 1. Okay, so now I have a trinomial like I did in the above problems. I need numbers that multiply together to be this. Oh, it could be 4 times 5. It could be 2 times 10. Over here, we just have 1 times 1. Okay, so I'm going to start with the numbers closer together. I'm going to start with these. Now, the 4b squared just comes down, and I make my binomial. So in this position here, I'm going to put the 5, the b, and a 4, b, and a 1 and a 1 over here. And now I'm going to figure out my signs by doing the smile method. 1 times 4 is 4b. 5b times 1 is 5b. I put down here what I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get this. Right? So I put this down here, negative 9b. So I could get a negative 9b if both of these were negative. So I know that both of these have to be negative. Lastly, I want to check my last term is a positive 1, is a negative 1 times a negative 1 a positive 1? Yes. So these are my factors. Okay, my next example has 4 terms. When you have 4 terms, you're going to do factor by grouping. Okay? So we're going to follow the method factor by grouping. But before we do that, we need to see if there's a greatest common factor. Is there a number that divides into all of these numbers? Yes, there is. So the first step, I want to take out my greatest common factor. My greatest common factor in this problem is 3. So we'll take the 3 out of, that means dividing it out of everything. And I'm left with r cubed plus 3r squared minus r minus 3. Okay, so now I'm going to factor by grouping. So to do this, I group the first 2 items together, and I go to group the second 2. Now, when I group the second 2, I notice that this is a negative. So when I group it, I must change the sign of this. So instead of a negative, I must change it to a positive. So now, from each group, I want to take out their greatest common factor. So this group here, it looks like they share a r squared. So my 3, he just comes down for the ride. This group shared an r squared. So I'm taking that out, and I'm going to be left with an r plus 3. Okay, now minus, let's just rewrite what we have, minus r plus 3. Okay. So now, I know that this has become one of my factors, because they match. So let's go ahead and write it here. That's going to be a, let's put some more brackets here. This will be r plus 3, is one of the factors. The 3 will just come right down and join it. Now the things that's left, r squared minus, you have to put a 1 here. This goes here. R squared minus 1. Now we're almost done. But I see that this here is the difference of perfect squares. So I have to keep factoring, cannot stop here. So this will factor into an R plus 1 times an R minus 1. Then we bring down the rest of the problem, r plus 3, and a 3. And now we have our final answer. Okay, next problem, number 5. Factor x cubed minus 5x squared minus 9x plus 45. So the first thing I do is I look for a greatest common factor. But I don't see one. They don't all share something. So, because there's 4 terms, I know that I'm going to factor by grouping. Factor by grouping. So, the first thing I'm going to do is group the first 2 terms, group the second 2, but I notice that this is a negative. There's a negative here. When I have a negative here in the middle, negative middle term, then just like a problem before, then I must change the sign of the last term. Just like we did in the problem before. So I must change this sign. So when I go to group it, now I have to change this. I'm going to change it and make it a negative and take out the positive. Let's rewrite it down here first. So we have x cubed minus 5x squared in a group minus 9x minus 45. Okay, so from this group here, I want to take out the greatest common factor. They share an x squared. So I pull out the x squared and I'm left with x minus 5. Over here, they both share a factor of 9. Take the 9 out and I'm left with x minus 5. Okay? So now I know these are both matching, so this becomes one of my factors. The things that are left, this and this part here, become my second factor. And I'm almost to the end. But when I look at this problem, I see that this is the difference of perfect squares. So I know that this factors farther. So x squared minus 9, just looking at this piece, will factor into an x plus 3 times an x minus 3. So now I'm going to rewrite my problem. So I have this comes down. I have my x minus 5 times x plus 3 times x minus 3. And I have my solution.